So first I take my aloe vera, I start chopping it up, I cut out the sides, remove the poison. Before I did this, I actually put the aloe vera upside down so the yellow, itchy part of the aloe vera can just seep away. Sorry for not showing you that. That was actually what I did before I started cutting out the chuku-chuku sides, the spiky sides of the aloe vera. Now, after doing that, I divided the aloe vera into two and then I scraped into a mortar, and I'll be using mortar and pestle to blend it. Please, if you have a blender, use a blender. I didn't have access to a blender this particular day, so I decided to use a mortar and pestle, which wasn't really effective, but I was able to get something out of it. So I'm just going to speed it up so I don't waste you guys' time. Aloe vera helps to reduce hair shedding. It promotes hair growth by stimulating blood circulation in the scalp. It fights dandruff. It gives your hair a shiny appearance. It moisturizes the hair. It serves as having antibacterial, antimicrobial properties. So what I'm trying to do here now is I'm trying to sieve out the aloe vera juice, because it's really the juice, or should I say gel? Let me say juice. It's really the aloe vera juice we need, not all these chunks. So I'm doing a DIY strainer. So I'm using a V-cap to strain out the juice from the rest of the chunks of the aloe vera. So aloe vera is very, very good for the hair. If you want long, healthy, shiny hair, because it also increases, gives the hair a shiny appearance. So, but you have to use it regularly. It's not something you just use once and stop. For the next part, we are going to start by boiling water. We are going to be using hibiscus, also known as zobo leaves in Nigeria. We are going to make a tea out of it and be adding it to the aloe vera juice. So this is my hibiscus, aka zobo leaf. It's dried. I suggest you buy the dried one because it's easier to make the tea. So I'm putting the hibiscus, dry hibiscus zobo leaves into a mug. Please use a mug, don't use a glass cup or anything like that, because the mug can withstand heat. Then I'm pouring my zobo leaf, my hot water into the zobo leaf, and I am covering, and I am going to leave till it changes from hot to warm or tepid. So I think that took about an hour and a half or 2 hours, can't really remember. So I'm going to strain the juice from the leaves with this strainer, and my hibiscus tea is ready. Hibiscus enhances blood circulation, therefore promoting hair growth. It helps to relieve itchy scalp. Guys, I have itchy scalp, and this, together with some other things I do in my regimen, helps my itchy scalp to reduce. It also reduces dandruff or flaky scalp, be it seborrheic dermatitis, dandruff itself, or just product buildup. It helps to reduce flaking in any way. It slows down hair graying for those who are afraid of getting older and having gray hair. This can slow down the process of graying hair. It also conditions the hair, conditions the scalp, providing moisture, and then it reduces frizz. So I mixed the zobo and the aloe vera together, and I'm applying on my scalp. Make sure you apply on your scalp. I'm using an applicator bottle. Guys, if you want to do this, please do this inside your sink in the bathroom or in your bathtub or shower, so you don't get stained. Just bend forward and pour the hibiscus into your hair strands and on your scalp. So I'm taking down the twist that I twisted my hair in previously so that the hibiscus will be able to reach every strand of hair. So that's what I'm trying to do now. So after I take it down,
I go ahead and apply the hibiscus and aloe vera tea rinse to my hair. Make sure I start from the ends, work it into my hair, go to the roots. Make sure I do it in every, I apply it to every part of my hair. So that's basically what I do. So these aloe vera and hibiscus have very good benefits to the hair. It's not just, you know, something that it actually works. I've used it a few times and I feel it works. It works very well. It helps me promote growth and everything together with every other thing I'm doing. Please do not just do this tea, this hibiscus aloe vera tea only and expect to see difference. You can check my other YouTube videos. I'll put link in the description box. I usually give tips on how to grow your natural hair long and thick. So I have so many videos on that. So don't just focus on this video because of what you're seeing and think, oh, this is what helps hair grow. No, you have to have a wholesome regimen. Like, you have to have a list of things that you do that will help you to promote hair growth. You know, your hair is growing no matter what. You're just trying to retain the length that you have grown. So this is part of what I do, but it is not the only thing I do. Please, I just want you to note that. If you are doing this hair treatment, this tea rinse, hibiscus aloe vera tea rinse, it's not that you apply it and then rinse it off immediately. You apply on every strand of the hair, make sure you use it to the maximum, then you put inside a plastic bag or nylon bag or whatever you call it, waterproof. And you keep it in your hair for about, let's say, 1 hour, 30 minutes, 1 hour. You can even go to 2, 3, 4 hours if you have the time. But I was pressed for time, so I did this for about, I think, 1 hour, or was it 45 minutes? And then you leave in your hair for the product to work, for the mixture to work, leave it. And then after 1 hour, I came back. And just to show you guys what my hair is looking like, my hair feels juicy. Please note that I had a whole wash day before I applied this, and I'll be posting that video next, so watch out for the wash day video, my dandruff wash day video. So this is what my hair is looking like. It felt so soft, silky smooth, no frizz, shiny, scalp was clean. I really, really enjoy using this mixture for my hair. And I believe, as I've told you guys about the benefits, I believe it will work for you if you do it consistently. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to like this video. Subscribe to my YouTube channel for more on natural hair growth. And thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.